The idea behind National Pet Week is, among other things, to promote responsible pet ownership and to teach people how to look after their animals. As part of the People Need Pets, Pets Need People theme, there was a variety of people and pets on show at the launch today. One of the main points emphasised by all the dog experts here was that training your pet is not only good for you, it's good for the dog too. Katie Boyle, whose three dogs, Baba, Busy and Charlie Girl, were once all strays, agrees.
They must not do things where they should not do it, because I have three rescue dogs, may I say, and they have all, therefore, had to be retrained. And they are living proof that you retrain. I don't know how old they were when I first got them, probably four, five, six, I haven't the slightest idea. But I taught them out and about rules. And I do not expect anybody to be a nuisance, any one of them to be a nuisance to anybody who may not like dogs as much as I do.
And those of you who keep animals, did you know that animals like humans have a body language all their own?
They inherit a lot of important body language from the wolf, the way they carry their bodies, their ears, their tail, their fur on their back. But also, you know, dogs are jolly good at copying people. And they copy a lot of our expressions, including the way that they pose on the front seat of a car, just trying to look like the driver who's just vacated it. They're very clever mimics. Cats can say a great deal by the position of their tail when they're coming to greet us. When they're pleased to see us, the tail is pointing forward. When it is thrashing from side to side, I think it's time to leave home.
There's a little rabbit here which is sort of looking very twitchy and nervous. What do you think that rabbit's trying to say?
I think that rabbit would like to be about 6 feet underground in its burrow, I might say. And I think...
And National Pet Week, involving shows, veterinary advisory evenings, grooming competitions and even doggy dinner parties, goes on till May the 7th. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.